Hello, everyone, and welcome to Enablers Junction, episode 6. I'm Jen. You can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Small Town Style. I am also the dyer behind the Perfect Stitch Fiber Co., and you can find, you can follow me and my dyeing adventures on Instagram at the Perfect Stitch Fiber Co., and you can find my shop on Etsy. Now, it has been quite a while since I have podcasted. I tried to podcast back, it was 2 days before Christmas Eve, I believe, and I ended up losing the light because I started podcasting so late. And so what we're actually going to do is travel back in time. I'm going to show you some of my FOs and my WIPs from that time. I'm going to attempt to edit everything to kind of flow together so it won't be too crazy. First up, we're going to travel back through time and take a look at what I'm some of my spinning. And when we come, when I see you back here in present time, I will show you what I am spinning. I am actually spinning now. All right. All right, guys. So first up, we've got spinning. This is my first sweater spin. I used created up by LCB's Storm and Atomic Blue Fibers Gummy Bear. Both were 4 ounce braids. And I wound up with 1,300 yards. So that's a good size for me for a sweater. Now I chose to do a fractal spin. And the colors in this are amazing. It amazes me when you're spinning how things kind of turn out. One skein has more purple than the other, which has more of the blues. And of course, I am not good at spinning 3 bobbins for singles equally. Not at all. Terrible. Never works out for me. So I wound up with 200 yards of whatever was on the first bobbin. I think it looks like there's some gummy bear in here. Not a lot, but there's some. And this, I just did a Navajo ply because I wasn't going to try and figure out any other way. It's like, yeah, I'll just throw that in there. So, but the beauty of it, I feel like, is it really goes to show you. I mean, even compare these two. It just depends. You could have the same fiber as me, and you could choose to spin it differently, and you will wind up, say, with this, while I wound up with this. So, I love that about spinning. So, that's my first sweater spin. I'm not entirely sure what sweater I'm going to cast on. I am glad this is done. I can't wait to get started on my next one, which happens to be my Starry Night spin. So I saw from Classy Squid Fiber Co. This is the Exploding TARDIS Rolex. This is 4 ounces. It's organic Polworth mulberry silk, Firestar Angelina, and I'm looking forward to spinning these. I also picked up a 4 ounce braid of Cheviot, and I plan on plying these two together. They will end up as a sweater. That's the goal anyway, is that they'll end up as a sweater. I may end up throwing in like a black or something. I'm not too sure. But I am excited. This is not, this spin won't start until January though, because there's too much to do from now till the end of the year. So this is gonna have to wait, but that's okay. I'm okay with that. All right, so I hope you enjoyed the first segment for spinning, and here's hoping that I actually had different segments. I don't remember, it was, because it is now February 3rd, so we're fast forward, we're going through like a month. Okay, so back at the end of December, I had originally planned on having my next spin be another sweater spin, and I actually had planned on spinning a Starry Night, which I believe I showed you in the last podcast, or in the last segment. But Classy Squid Fiber Co. has actually, hosting a spin-along. And up first, which I didn't finish in time, but I haven't been really feeling the spinning bug. So, but up first was a chain ply. And it's just about learning. I already have done chain plying, but I really wanted to do it. I decided that I would do, use my, these are the Icelandic Dreams mini bats, and it is a rainbow. There's so many. Let's see if I can do this. All right. Got paper. It attaches to everything. So, a rainbow. So, I thought that I wanted to spin these into yarn, chain ply them, and then I would knit them into socks. That's my plan. I am current, now since I have an 8-month-old, he likes to get to my wheel, so I have a hard time spinning with him awake, and so I have gotten through the other half of this. I already separated these in half. All of these are, this is only half of it. The other half is next to my wheel, and it is, I am on the orange color. I haven't gotten very far on that. Let's see, this fiber is this, or these mini bats are made up of American Targhee? Natural Gray Shetland, Mulberry Antissa Silk, Faux Cashmere Nylon, Firestar, and it is 2.2 ounces. I probably should weigh it to make sure, because there's a 2.2 plus, so it could be a little bit more than 2.2, and I didn't weigh it, but I did weigh out so that they were, each mini bat was equal in half, split in half, so I did do that. I currently have what is waiting to be spun in my steady hand. This is one of my steady hand, it's a large bag. I like to use them to hold my fiber that I'm going to be spinning. So if I have a project that, or I'm not really spinning very much at the moment, I like to separate them, and then I keep them nice and kind of together, so that way that they don't get, I don't end up losing something, or who knows, there's a long list of things. All right, so that is what I am spinning at the moment. That's what's on my wheel. Up next, we have FOs. And so we are going to go back in time. All right, guys, I don't want to talk too long, so I'm going to go quickly through my FOs. Most of them are Christmas knits. I have finally finished the Wee Susan, second one.
obviously ends aren't woven in and there's no buttons, but it'll get done eventually, hopefully. Also, I've got my second wee cupcake little cardigan. Again, haven't woven in the ends. It's like two ends too, and I haven't done it because I'm lazy. All right, so that was the wee cupcake cardigan. Okay, I did finish my husband's Seahawks socks. They are done, but they are wrapped, and they are in his stocking, which is over that way, on the other side. However, I knit my oldest son, Dean, a Christmas stocking when he was first born. I did a 2x2 rib. 2x2? Yeah. 2x2 rib stocking, because apparently, I don't know, I had a lot of time on my hands. I'm not too sure. However, for my youngest, I opted not to do 2x2 rib, but I knit him a stocking as well. So, despite him not knowing this, this is part of his Christmas present, because that's still a lot of knitting. Okay, that only took like a couple days, but still. That's good knitting time. And I'm a selfish knitter. I like to knit stuff for myself, not other people. Not that I don't like. Yeah, no. I like to selfish knit. All right. I also have my son's, my oldest son's, Ninja Turtle socks. All these colors are kind of getting a little bit. I'm losing a lot of the light fast. So I apologize for bad lighting. So for these, I decided to be different, and I did a pearl kind of design down the center. He wants to wear them all the time. I keep telling him, no, you can't, because it's not Christmas yet, and these are your Christmas present. I used, this is from Two Gray Dogs. They're Heroes in a Half Shell colorway. The colors are not, well, kind of coming up, kind of working. Okay, so, I think that's it. All right, so hopefully that worked. I don't know, we'll see. I hope you're back from the past. If you're not and I messed it up, I'm sure I'll include something here saying, whoops. So, I decided to join in all the knit-alongs for January, and I decided to make my first toe-up stripe, what else did I do? Oh, afterthought heel, first afterthought heel sock. It's a little bit longer. I made it a little bit longer. I don't know what I was thinking. I made myself a foot pattern, a foot stencil. Oops. We're having an earthquake. Sorry. Like this. But this is my husband's foot. He's got huge feet, just so you know. Huge. I don't know where mine is. It's somewhere. So these are my January socks. It is the Desert Vista Dye Works in the colorway Harold's Purple Crayon. I received this as one of the gifts in the Get Your Yarn Wishes Granted. I did the pattern is the Speckled Space Socks. And obviously you're not going to be really able to tell, but I think it's really cool. Now, with toe-up socks, I'm sure everyone knows this who's done toe-up socks, but I felt really, I kind of saw like, oh, you have to do a different bind off because obviously it needs to be stretchier. Well, I did this one and it did not work at all. So I ended up having to take it out and I ended up doing the one that has yarn overs.
And that worked out a lot better. I don't remember which one it is. Sorry. I should have put in notes. But I did, yeah, it worked out a lot better. I did end up going, I took out another row, another round, when I took out my bind off, because I wanted to make sure I had enough yarn, to do the bind off, and I didn't want to attach yarn. So I went back another one. And I did a true afterthought heel, complete with cutting, taking out the stitches, and then shoving the needles in. So that was a lot of fun. I kind of want to keep doing afterthought heels just because it was so much fun. But I don't know. My next sock, I'm not doing an afterthought heel, but I'll show that on my whips. So that is one of my only FOs. Is that, that's sad if that's the case. No. Well, all right. I'll also show you this. So, I showed my Cozy Memories blanket. Which I ended up ripping out most of it. Some of it I gave up on and said, forget it, I don't care. Yeah. Because I'm that person. Don't care. I decided to switch to the Brioche Memories blanket. And by Valerie, her last name is NG. I can't pronounce it, so I don't want to butcher it. So that's how it goes. So I've got some started, but here is my squares. So I actually started with a big square first, and I probably should have started with smaller ones, but I didn't want to. So it kind of made it a little wonky. But I do plan, I know I'll get better at this blanket thing, business, eventually. So I added a purple, which is from X-Ray Ann. The teal color is from Countess Blaze. This is my Funfetti Oreo Cupcake colorway. I feel like it's kind of getting blown out. It turned out I really wanted to knit with it. Do we have that over here? Somewhere? Maybe. I have my desk over there. Well, my big table that has everything, all my business stuff. And if it's on there, then it might be, but it may be on the shelf, so I don't know. Oh, and then I can't remember. This is Zippity Doodah. I still don't remember who did it. And then I have my Sucre Sucre miniature charm. It's cupcake. It's the snowflake one. This is not coming in right. Focus. Nope. I'm trying. It's not working today. But I'm determined. And then I have my Anne Tudor. And Tudor Cupcake Progress Keeper, which I also got. See, I forget. I have already podcasted these things, but I didn't because I never released it. And we're going back in time. I have to keep reminding myself that. So I'm sorry if things are really confusing. I really am sorry. So she also podcasts, but she sent me these in the Get Your Yarn Wishes Granted. And I am going to have that. I have to reshoot that. That was one of the segments that got lost. So yeah, that's my Brioche Memories blanket. I am super excited about it because I liked the Cozy Memories, but it just seemed, I don't know. I wasn't a huge fan of it. So that's basically why I was like, I'm ripping it out. I'm going to do this. And I love the squishiness. I feel like this is going to be, I will be a lot happier with it. And it's fun to do brioche because I really like that stitch. And so keeping with that is awesome. All right. So I don't have any other FOs. None at all. Other than what I've shown you. So, next up we're going to go back in time and I'm going to show you whips, and then we're going to come back to this time and I'm going to show you whips in present time. All right, guys, I'm back with the whips. First, I have my three-color cashmere cowl. It's going to be hard to see. The lighting is going to be bad. It's late. Sorry, guys. I lost the light. I'm using Malabrigo, and I can't remember what colors they were. It's in on Ravelry. It's in my notes, though. And then Firefly Fiber Arts Blueberry Waffle. Not Blueberry Waffle, sorry. Blueberry Ice Cream. I am using size 7 needles. This is a worsted weight yarn. So I've modified the stitch number. I believe I cast on 120. And this was based on taking a look at other people's projects with worsted weight. I'm using my Taco Sucre Sucre Miniature Progress Keeper, and that was how much I had gotten to last time that I showed this. So I've made good progress. Obviously, holiday knitting's gotten in the way of making substantial progress. I don't know what that was. Sorry, guys. Yeah. So I lost my train of thought now. It's okay. All right, and then up next, I've made some progress on my talisman shawl. Needle Cozy from the Steady Hand. All right. I haven't made much progress, but I've made some. It kind of got put on hold. But I haven't shown it in a while. Or I have, and you're seeing the same thing. And if so, I'm sorry. I apologize for that. If I have, I don't know. Probably should have watched to see where I was last time. It's been too long. This is what happens when it's been too long since you last podcast. You don't remember what you showed. Notes to self. Keep track of these things. I won't do it. This is a colorway I dyed myself. I love it. I may dye it and put it in the shop, but I'm not sure yet if that's going to happen. All right. I also have, I cast on a baby sweater. It is a test knit, so I don't have much done. I've been trying to get other stuff done, so I don't have too much. I think it'll be a fairly quick knit. It seems like it. If I actually took the time and sat down and did it, I think I could probably knock it out in a couple days. And since I wanted this to be a Christmas present, I probably should sit down and get it done. But there's another project I'm working on too. So it's kind of one of those, you gotta choose. You gotta choose. All right. I'll do this one. I also have, one baby sock. One baby sock done. This is actually for a baby. Not to be confused with the little teeny tiny socks that people do at Christmas. This is not one of those. This is for an actual baby. I am working on the second one. I have already turned the heel. And I just have the foot and the toe left. And I kind of came up with
how many stitches and or how many rounds. So I have 20 rounds, and I think it's less because I've done some. Maybe 19 now. So 19 rounds plus the toe. So super quick, I could finish this tonight if I would sit and do it. I should have had it done yesterday. These have to get done quickly because they need to be ready to go. And yet, I take forever. I don't know. All right. And of course, what I'm super excited about, I haven't shown for a while, is my Cozy Memories blanket. Side note, have you guys seen the Brioche Cozy Memories blanket? Because if you haven't, go check it out. It is a free Ravelry pattern. It is amazing, and oh my, the squishiness. I'm to the point where I want to take all of this out and start over with a Brioche version, because who doesn't want a Brioche squishy version of this? So, if you haven't checked it out, you should. I really wish I paid attention to who the designer was. I could look it up, but I'm trying to do this fast. So, I've got some more squares. I don't remember. I know. I think I'd already shown this one. This is not showing up very well. Oh, there we go. Kinda. Countess Ablaze, H2O. This is some hand spun. And I'm working on my watermelon square, which is going to be a large square, like the Zippity-Doo-Dah from someone. Can't remember. Sorry about this. I believe this one was new also, so I had the Progress Keeper. And this, I think, is from Rockin' String. This might also be from Rockin' String. So, I'm making progress. It's not my go-to, obviously. I just kind of do, I work on it whenever. So, it's just kind of for now. And it lives in my study handbag. Alright guys, so hopefully you enjoyed all of that. I had a lot of whips. I did end up finishing the baby socks. I have no idea where they are. Nope, they're somewhere. But I don't know where they're at. Alright, so I already showed you my Brioche Memories blanket. I'm doing a solid color next. It's a hot pink, and you kind of saw that. But I'm going to focus on my February socks. So, I'm doing the mystery, if you guys bear with me, sorry. I'm way out of practice on this. And things are a little crazy. Sorry. My yarn got tangled. My little yarn ball for my Brioche Memories blanket got tangled. This is the pink I'm using. I feel like it's not really. There we go. Kinda. We'll see. Alright. It's a jumbled mess. You wanna see it? Oh, and it's currently living in my Silver Shed USA ginormous project bag. My mother got it for me for Christmas, so I was super excited about it. So excited. So my blanket is living in there, and then I threw my socks in because I was going to knit last night in bed after I got my boys down, and I ended up falling asleep because I was so tired. So, didn't happen, but that's okay. So, anyway, I am participating in the Curl Pearl Girls, I think that's right, Curl Pearl Girls Mystery Sock Knit Along. It's a year-long mystery sock knit along. What you had to do was get all of your yarn together and put them in bags and then have someone else label them. So I have all my yarn in a box ready to go. For February, I pulled, here's the yarn I pulled. Okay, it's attached. So I pulled it's the Speckles
or it's a custom colorway that I had made from Leon Alexander Yarns. I don't believe that they have their Etsy shop. I believe they are strictly doing wholesale now. I've discovered them months and months and months ago. And I am disappointed because I wanted this yellow and pink colorway and I just didn't. I never got it. And now they're wholesale. Oh well, that's okay. Okay, so I'm doing that for the main part of the sock. And then I have this fabulous blue. Let's see, is that gonna help? Maybe. This fabulous blue with purples. And I have started the second cuff. I love the look of the jelly roll socks. And for the longest time, this is how smart I am, right? Longest time, I was like, man, that looks really just like the Rose City Rollers. Same designer. I didn't realize it till yesterday. I was looking at, like, okay, well, how do they do? Okay, I like the cuff part. Not necessarily the entire sock. I like the cuff part. I mean, it's a great sock. It's a great design. But for me, I just wanted the cuff. So I did some thinking, figured out a few things, and I have my first cuff. So my first cuff is done for my February sock. I'm still debating if I'm going to do a pattern or not. There's a pattern I'm considering. But I'm not sure I'm going to do it. We'll see. So the blue has sparkle, which is cool, and kind of fun. And then it's a perfect, it just kind of matches with the blue in the, and the purple in the, main color. So in the custom color. So yeah, I did 17 rounds, for the first cuff. And then the second cuff, I did 12 because I thought, you know, I wanted to have that differentiate, but I wanted it to roll. So yeah. And then this sock, I am going to be doing a heel flap and gusset, which I haven't done since my first Rose City Rollers pair, which actually... I forgot I brought it here. Let me put on the blocker. Sorry guys, I am just kind of out of it today, I guess. Life is funny. Okay, so Rose City Rollers. I always loved this. And then so the heel flap, I'm just gonna use that pattern for the heel flap. I think what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to alternate the colors. So I'm going to do a color work sock, basically. I think I'm going to, or do a slip stitch. A slip stitch. Oh, I have it on my project page. I found a pattern for it to do a slip stitch, and then you do different colors. Or you do the two different colors. So that, I think, is my plan, is to use this and the main color for it. But I'm kind of figuring it out. So I don't do well with socks and not having a pattern to go on. Well, not my, like a straight pattern. I haven't done it. So long story short, that's my February sock. I'm super excited for it. I can't wait to finish these ones. I'm hoping it takes me far less time than it took for the January sock, because the January sock took me all month. We were sick. It was like everything. It just was not good. All right, so that is my February sock. They are now going to be living as I take my other one out, other yarn out. They are, what is this? I need these for those. Okay. I probably need a nap too. I got this messy. I really wish I could insert music right now. Just to make it so you don't have to wait for me. Okay, so this is in one of my new steady hand bags. It is a small size? Small size. And you can find her on Etsy. April is awesome. I use this as my fancy bag. I used it for my husband's holiday party. I got it in the mail that day, and then I took it, and I put my socks in it, and went away, and knit a little bit, not much, because turned out I'd forgotten my cable needle. And I do not do well with not using a cable needle. I end up dropping stitches, and it's just not good. Okay. So, let's see. I also did... I know I did this. I showed the start of the baby sweater that I'm test knitting. We have a sweater. I was waiting on... They ended up changing the sizing or the stitches and a lot of it. They ended up changing it. And... which was good. But this one, it fits, except for I needed to do a stretchy bind off. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just re-knit the body. I have plenty of yarn. So I'm going to re-knit it. I was waiting on a 9-inch circular, in size 6 so I could do the sleeves, and it took like a month to get to me, which was pain in the butt. But what can you do? Nothing. All right. So that's one whip that is I kind of got progress on, and also and there we go. And that's all that she wrote. My cardigan, and I haven't made much progress on it since then. And it's currently living in my steady, or my silver shed. Yeah, my silver shed USA extra large project bag with the Starry Night pattern. All right, sorry about that, guys. Yeah, little man woke up, so... next up is a new segment called Winner Winner Chicken Dinner. Because, you know, sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. I was one of 10 winners of the Lolo Did It 10,000 giveaway. And I actually won a pretty young thing. Oh my gosh, and I love this. It is gorgeous. It's amazing. I love it. God Save the Queen sock. Oh, the colors and the speckles, and I love it so much. So much. Super generous. I couldn't believe it. I had all of this stuff that I received, because it wasn't just this. I also got little extras. So I also got some stitch markers and a tape measurer. Those I believe she has in her shop. My son likes to steal it from me because he thinks it's a toy. These kids, I swear. You have to see this though. Come on. Purple speckles. Purple speckles. And my son, of course, ripped off the tag, and that made me sad, but it's still kind of there. So that was awesome. And then up next, I have the hashtag get your yarn wishes granted segment. So I hope everyone participated in that. I know that I was filming this about less than a month after when I first did this segment. It was less than a month after it took place. And I really want to just say I can't believe the amazing generosity that is in the knitting community. I had so much fun granting wishes. I don't know how many I did. I had capped it off. I had said, I'm only going to do this many because that's all I can do. I wish I could have done more. It would have been fabulous, but you can't always do it. So, just a couple things. So I had a few of my yarn wishes granted. And at this point, you've already seen the Desert Vista Dye Works yarn in my sock, because I have the other one somewhere, but it's, yeah. So there are, just for the record, it is an actual finished object. It is all completely done. But Hannah, the lovely Hannah, granted me this wish, and oh my gosh, these are exactly my colors. I could not have, I feel like I was so, because you never know, like, people are generous enough to donate or gift you a skein of yarn, but you don't know. I was not, like, a specific color, and it was perfect, absolutely perfect. And then also, Shannon gifted me a winter project bag, and how cute is this? It is amazing. So Shannon is of Woodsy and Wild. You can find her on Etsy and Instagram. I think she's Woodsy and Wild on Instagram. Pretty sure. So, yeah. Oh, my gosh. And it's amazing. And I gotta go. And there's a D-ring. And it's awesome. And then Anne from Anne Tudor LLC granted me my cupcake progress keepers. And I had a bunch of them. And I showed you one. So, yeah. I'm sorry. Hang on. All right, guys. My co-host is going to be joining us for a little while. And I actually did find the Lolo did it tape measure, which is awesome. So I wanted to show you guys that as part of the last segment. All right. So up next, we have Hubby Doesn't Know, aka Acquisitions. I have shown you a few of them because... obviously, yeah, they are holding things. So I showed you my Silver Shed USA project bag that my mother got me for Christmas, and it has the kind of stained glass owls, and then also the Starry Night print, which I got from Small Business Saturday, which was forever ago at this point because it's February. I also ordered from Firefly Fiber Arts. I ordered some fiber. Ooh, you're getting into this, aren't you? Sorry, guys. Oh, you're there you go. Sorry, guys. Yeah, he wants all the fiber. He likes yarn. Do you want to see this yarn? You want to see this yarn? Okay. So, ordered Firefly. Alright, so I also ordered from Firefly Fiber Arts. And I got this gorgeous silver Stellina. It's called Partly Cloudy, and it's a hand, because there's the blue, we've got white and gray, and some navy going on, a little bit darker, yep. And also, I reordered this gorgeous skein called Hibiscus Cloud. And it is an 80/20 superwash merino nylon. And there's 426 yards. All right, and oh, before I forget, I also, because you know, you just kind of keep ordering stuff, I also placed an order from Created by LCB. I ordered Derby Girl, which I should probably take out of the bag, but I'm lazy, so I'm not going to. Arabian Nights. I think that's right. Arabian Nights. And this is the one that has the more gray and not as much blue. She was going to switch that up. And that's... what's the base again? It's Merino Rose Gold Stellina. So 50% 18 micron Merino, 25% rose fiber, 17% 25 micron Merino, and 8% sparkle. And then also, I got Sugar Plum, and it is 16% silver Stellina, 84% 19 micron Merino. So I loved when they're extra soft. They're so much fun to spin. And I didn't say what this one was. The Derby Girl is 21 micron superwash, 85% 21 micron superwash, and 15% metal. And that, I almost forgot. Firefly Fiber Arts, I got Gemini Progress Keeper. Did you find fiber? Yeah, he found fiber. So, that is all I have for Hubby Doesn't Know. So, first things first, I'm going to do shop news next. I'm going to do shop news next. If you don't want to stay tuned for that, that's fine. Thank you so much for sticking through with me. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Happy yarning. And no, you don't play with mommy's fiber like that. Here, play with this. This is my skein, by the way. So next up will be shop update if you want to stay tuned for that. If not, thank you for watching. See you next time. All right, guys, it's Perfect Stitch Fiber Co. update time. So I have been dying. Well, I was dying up a storm, I should say. I'm not necessarily doing it anymore. I died a bunch. And some is sold. So if there was some that you were hoping you'd see, some of them sold out fast. But just real fast, here is my berry scones in the snow colorway. There are blue speckles and a deep orchid color. There is also winter berries with the deep orchid speckles and the blue stripe going. I also have tidal pools, which is mint, like a peppermint color, and gray. Oh, and in addition to that, I have new bases. I finally got the Merino Cashmere Nylon. So this is my K-Money base. I also have a Deluxe Chief base because it is extra fine Merino. This one. It's on the extra fine Merino. So it's just softer. And it's still the 4-ply. So it's still... it makes for really sturdy socks. Nope, that's my MCN. Here is Funfetti Oreo. All the speckles. So much speckles. And then I did a... I now have a Funfetti Cupcake line. So I have red velvet, chocolate stripe, blueberry, which is my blueberry. So it's a darker blue. And this is on my glam base. So it's gold Stellina. So it's 438 yards. 75% superwash fine merino, 20% nylon, and 5% gold stellina. And I love the gold stellina. And also, I have a blue velvet. The blue is a lighter blue. Well, not like a light blue, but it's lighter than the blueberry. And that is also on the gold stellina. The red velvet and the chocolate stripe sold, so I do not have those to show, but I will be dyeing them again. And then this is my confetti cupcake, which I will change the name to Funfetti Cupcake, just to stick with the, but, so some will be called the confetti cupcake, but they will be having a name change. I also have a chunky vase. This is Aurora Borealis on my chunky vase, which I love and I think would make a really pretty cowl. And I also have confetti cupcake. And this is 96% merino, 4% nylon. So, it is not superwash, which I'm pretty sure, if I remember right, it is the only base that I have that is not superwash. Most of my bases are superwash, mostly because, and I know some people don't like superwash, I do superwash not so that I can wash it in the washing machine, but actually because it's a little bit easier for me. I am a little bit allergic to wool, and so my sensitivities, because of my sensitivities, it makes it a little bit easier. I can handle like merino, and I can handle dealing with wools, but wearing them, I get itchy. So I've just been carrying it, and I don't know that I'll change that. It may continue that way. So, I'm sorry if that's, you know, that is what it is. I do plan on releasing, having some fiber, more fiber though. And I plan on, carrying a few different fun things. I have plans. But for now, this is what we've got. And then this is Berry Blizzard, which is blue and purple sparkles. Yeah. So, thank you for sticking with me. I have been really enjoying getting to know everybody on Instagram. I've been really enjoying having fun in this knitting community. I've been enjoying the knit-alongs. Just so many. So, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye! Alright. My second co-host wanted to join in for a little quick hi. Say hi.
Hi.
All right. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.
See you next time.
See you next time.